Trojan Sports Now.
Hello and welcome to Trojan Sports Now. I'm Danielle Percival.
And I'm Jonathan Sellers. Stick around as we bring you the latest news and scores from Troy Sports.
Well, the Troy baseball team opened up conference play over the weekend, taking on South Alabama, but also taking on the weather. The Trojans and Jags were scheduled to play 3 games over 3 days, but Mother Nature had other plans. The Trojans took game one with an excellent outing by Tanner Hicks. Hicks threw a complete game shutout, giving up 6 hits and struck out 5. Home runs from Nick Masonia and David Hall helped lead the Trojans offensively. And game two was a classic pitcher's duel that went the way of the Jags 2-1 in 10 innings. Both teams got on the board with a run in the second, but from there the pitching took over. Shane McCain threw 8 innings, giving up 5 hits and striking out 2, while Jeremy McGowan took the loss in relief. And the teams tried to fit game three in Saturday night, and the Trojans were actually winning 3-1 heading into the fourth. However, the rain came and the game was called and later canceled, with the rain continuing into Sunday. But for Coach Bobby Pierce, the story for him on the weekend was Tanner Hicks and his outing, earning him Sunbelt Pitcher of the Week.
He just competed so hard, and he got out of a couple of jams that he got in, and defensively we made a couple of nice diving stops to kind of counter some base hits it looked like they might have had off the bat. You combine that together, you get a shutout, but I thought it was more Tanner's competitive nature than just his raw stuff that he was throwing that really led him down that road to a CG shutout.
And the Trojans return home to open a 5-game homestand on Tuesday as they look to whoop Jack State. But an early deficit made the task tough for the Trojans. Amy Austin has the story.
A rough start to the game did it in for the Troy University baseball team as they faced Jacksonville State. The Trojans lost 7-3 to the Gamecocks on Tuesday night.
Getting down that early in the ball game, and sometimes, you know, that early's good. I mean, you got 9 innings left to play. You got an opportunity to come back. Chip away, maybe take a lead, but we never could really get the big inning we needed to get back in position. So credit Jacksonville State. They played a better ball game than us tonight.
While Troy did score 3 runs, the hitting kept the Trojans from coming back. 8 Trojans were unsuccessful at the plate.
We gave up 5 in the inning. That put us behind the 8-ball, and with the way our team's scoring, that was going to be a difficult task to overcome, and you hate to see that early in the game.
After the first 2 Trojan pitchers were roughed up, Austin Sullivan came out and pitched 6 innings, having only 2 hits and 19 at-bats, giving the Trojans a chance.
Thought Austin Sullivan pitched great for us. I think he went 6 or 7 innings and didn't give up a run. And I mean, when you come in and you do that for your team, it gives you a chance to get back in the game.
Troy has to prepare immediately for another midweek game tonight against Alabama State.
Pitched well. We've defended fairly well. Now all we got to do is add a little offense, and we should get our team turned back around. So easier said than done, but we're certainly searching for that moment to get us turned around.
Well, on Wednesday, the Trojans were playing too, well, kind of. Alabama State was in town to finish up a game that was delayed in the 8th inning last week because of rain, and then the 2 teams were scheduled to play a regular 9-inning game. Amy Austin was there and has the details of a good night for the Trojans.
It's not often the Troy baseball team gets 2 wins on 1 day in the middle of the week, but Wednesday night, Troy did just that. In completing the postponed game, Troy defeated ASU 8-5. Game 2 was also a victory as the Trojans took an 8-5 win from the Hornets.
We come into the first game with an 8-3 lead, and you're going, boy, is 3 runs enough? And then Shell, you know, starts it off with a walk and a hit by pitch to bring the tying run to the plate. So that's not the way we really wanted to start. But then he turned it around, made some great pitches.
The hitting finally came around for the Trojans. Joel Bennett went 3-for-3, with one of his hits being a 2-run homer. Matthew Howard also had a 2-run homer to give the Trojans an even bigger lead. Nick Masonia finished the game going 2-for-4.
Got a few timely hits today. Boy, we've been waiting on those, you know. And just really overall a better effort from our team, something that hopefully they will be able to move forward with a little positive momentum. We've been kind of really squeezing tight, you know, with trying not to make mistakes, and we continue to make them, especially at the plate.
With the 2 victories over Alabama State, the Trojans are looking for the momentum to continue into the weekend as ULM heads to Troy for a weekend of conference play.
But tonight, I think, might give us a chance to relax a little bit, and not in the wrong way, but in the right baseball way. So hopefully we can continue moving forward with a good feel going into the weekend against Monroe.
The Trojan softball team was on the road at the Chanticleer Showdown, entering with the reigning Sun Belt Player of the Week, Ebony Wright. The Trojans finished the tournament with only one win, but it came in their opening game. The Trojans picked up a 6-2 victory over the host team Coastal Carolina to begin the tournament. The Trojans got the help of back-to-back home runs by Amanda Winters and J.C. Affelt. Affelt entered in relief of Ashley Rainey, who picked up the win, while Affelt earned the save. The Trojans struggled with a loss to Fordham 9-1 to open play on Saturday before facing back-to-back games against a ranked Minnesota team. The Trojans were unable to find any success against the Golden Gophers with a 2-0 loss on Saturday and a 4-2 defeat on Sunday. On the weekend, though, Amanda Winters was named to the all-tournament team for her solid hitting performance.
The basketball season has come to an end, and while there were some good moments during the year, March Madness and the Sun Belt Tournament did not work out like the Trojans would have liked. The men's basketball team fell to Arkansas Little Rock in the first round of the tournament 74-61. The game was tied at the half, but a cold shooting touch in the second half let UALR put the game out of reach. The Trojans had four players score in double figures, led by Tevin Calhoun, who had 15. For Troy, it was the final game for six seniors, and the coaching staff knows they left it all on the court, not just in this game, but all season.
Seniors that we had, it was a tough deal for them, you know, having to adjust to a new coaching staff, you know, being their last year playing. But they were great all year. They came in with a great work ethic, came in and did everything we asked them to do. And the results were we were able to make it to the tournament in New Orleans. You know, not everybody made it. You know, with the format for the new year, only the 8 teams can go. That was one of our goals, to make sure these seniors got to experience that.
The women's basketball team secured their spot in the tournament earlier than the men, but weren't able to stay in New Orleans any longer. The women were up against the other Trojans from the Sun Belt as well and lost their first round game to UALR 66-54. The Trojans suffered a few scoring droughts, including nearly 7 minutes late in the second half. The Trojans finished their second year under head coach Shanda Rigby at 12-18 and 8-10 in conference play. The team struggled early on with an 8-game losing streak at one point, but associate head coach Jennifer Graff said the team continued fighting and turned the season around.
We did see a ton of improvement this year that we saw from the previous year, and that's what we're trying to do here. It's just to build this program, and we won 5 additional games last year. We won 5 more this year than the year before. So, you know, we're hoping we can get on up there again and have that winning record next season. And if these girls keep working and keep improving like they had been during the year, then obviously our future looks really bright.
The Trojans lost 3 seniors from this year's squad, including Joanna Harden, who only had 2 seasons at Troy but made the most of them. This year, Harden set the Troy single-season scoring record with 754 points.
Take away the first round, and the Trojans are walking away with the title at the Seminole Intercollegiate in Tallahassee. Troy shot 5 under during the second day's 36 holes, which was a stroke better than 12th-ranked Florida State. However, the opening day round of 302 got the Trojans behind out of the gate and had them playing catch-up. But the second day's finish allowed the Trojans to climb up to 5th overall for the tournament. Jared Betcher was tied for 12th overall, while Tolver Dozier and Jake Tucker finished tied for 16th.
The Trojan track and field team competed at the USF Invitational over spring break in Tampa and came away with some top finishes. The men's team swept the 4x100 with a first and second place finish and also had 2 teams in the top 3 in the 4x400 relay. Benjamin Martin won the 100-meter dash for the second week in a row, and Thaddeus Curtis brought home first place in the 100-meter hurdles and 400-meter hurdles. The women's team brought home first in the 4x100-meter relay also. The 4x400-meter relay team came in third. Julia Ostendorf finished 3rd in the 3K, running a 10:29, and Karina Cox won first place in the discus with a throw of 46.82 meters, and that is the second straight competition she has won the discus in.
The men's and women's rodeo teams competed at the Southern Arkansas Rodeo last weekend, with the men finishing 7th and the women 6th. Nelson Wyatt had all the points for the men with a second place finish in the steer wrestling.
The Trojan men's tennis team picked up a home win over the weekend, defeating Xavier of Louisiana 6-1 Saturday afternoon. Troy won the doubles point with Gabriel Chacadiaz and Pablo Marino taking on the 12th-ranked doubles pair in the NAIA rankings. Then on Wednesday, the men played host to Bradley and continued their winning streak, defeating Bradley 4-1. On the women's side, the Trojans were in action in Boca Raton, Florida, and picked up 2 victories over Florida Atlantic and Boston University. Both matches were close, including edging out Boston in a 4-3 victory. Well, still to come on Trojan Sports Now, we'll have a look at baseball's conference home opener and the softball start to conference play, plus all the other Trojans that are in action.
But first, with baseball back in town this weekend, we're going to take a look at some of their highlights for their early home schedule. Stick around for more Trojan Sports Now.